You can use the same sleeves the best players in the world use, Channel Fireball sleeves. And what better way to carry them than in a Channel Fireball deck box? And if you want to play like the best, you have to dress like the best. Channel Fireball shirts, hats, hoodies, and more are all available in the apparel section of ChannelFireball.com. Head to ChannelFireball.com/store to find all of your gaming supplies.
Hey guys, this is Pat Cox. Welcome to a Theros draft here on Channel Fireball. Have not been drafting a whole lot lately because I've been working on various white weenie decks, but have a GP in Sacramento that's sealed in about a month here, so figured I should probably try and keep up my Theros skills or maybe learn some Theros skills if I don't have any. And we open an Elspeth, which is pretty lucky. Probably the best card you could possibly open. Nothing else in the pack's remotely close. I guess if it wasn't here, I'd probably take Coordinated Assault. This card's pretty great for turning on heroic triggers and also just any cheap combat trick like that's pretty nice. And I guess if not that, probably Hopeful Eidolon. I don't know. I don't like picking that card that early. So maybe Ordeal. This is the worst Ordeal, though. Anyway, we will take the Elspeth. Okay, so we got a Steam Augury, which does not go with our Elspeth and is also not particularly insane. It's fine. Dauntless Onslaught does go with Elspeth, so that's definitely a contender. Again, we have Hopeful Eidolon. Griptide Lash. I think Griptide's probably the best card in the pack. Probably like goes Griptide, Dauntless, Lash, and Hopeful are pretty close to each other. I think given that we first picked Elspeth and Dauntless, Onslaught, and Griptide are pretty close, that like this might even be better, that I should probably just take Dauntless, Onslaught. At least make a go of having an Elspeth deck. Well, probably table one of these. Maybe not. People are on board with this card being pretty good, but you want, like, maybe two in your deck. Probably one. So, yeah, we open an Artisan of Forms, which is good, not insane, but pretty good. We didn't open, got passed. And, I don't know, between the Eidolon and the Chosen by Helioid, white does seem reasonably open. Hoplite's like another option, but it's not so good that I want to like put myself into another color. It's probably Chosen by Helioid or Hopeful Eidolon if I'm going to take a white card. I think Artisan might be good enough that it's worth just go ahead and take this. See if I don't know if I'll end up blue, but Well, this is a good constructed card. It's not particularly good and limited. It's okay still. Could have a nice Minotaur deck so far. Second one of these I've seen, maybe third. So nothing blue. We do have a Disciple, which is good in like the mono black deck that we're not necessarily seeing. And then we have this guy, who's good, not great, and Chosen by Helioid, which I think is actually kind of great. Granted, you need things to go with it, but I mean, we already have the Artisan. So yeah, I'm going to take Chosen by Helioid. That's my favorite of those. That cycle. A lot of people like the red one, which is also good, but I don't know, this just lets you start triggering heroic, but even without heroic, just lets you start attacking through their guys immediately. Pretty good in any kind of aggressive deck. Well, here we have a bunch of mediocre cards, though a lot of playable cards. Any of these red cards I'm not totally unhappy with, or at least these two can be easily be my main deck. Like Last Breath, Battle Priest, and Warden are all pretty eh. Last Breath is a reasonable sideboard card though. So I suppose we'll take that. Like Battle Priest can make my main deck. I'm not too unhappy if it does, if I don't have it though. Well, Battlewise Hoplite's pretty sweet, and there's a decent chance we'll end up in blue based on what we have so far. Also, I've seen some green reasonably open, so that's another possibility. But because all this really tells us is this exact color combo is open, not necessarily the blue's open. But unless we want to take a Silent Artisan, which I don't have a problem with the three of them pure bloods, but not looking to take it either. Divine Verdict or Eidolon? I guess Eidolon. Yeah. I could be wrong, but I think it's right. Well, otherwise I wouldn't do it, so probably a pointless statement. Yeah, I just don't really like leaving up Divine Verdict. It's pretty weak removal, and also just like with all the bestow guys, and you know, it's killing like half a guy a lot of the time. So yeah, I guess it's this. This is a good sideboard card, but this I will main deck and be reasonably happy about it, so. Battle Priest is the most likely to make my main deck. This card's fine, as is this, but this is definitely a sideboard fodder. This may or may not be. Also, we're not 100% in blue yet. We have two blue cards. We're definitely in white. Yeah, I don't know. Guess this, whatever. I take a card that I was worried about, but that isn't even there. I mean, I guess I could have taken Spark Jolt, maybe. This card's pretty terrible. Maybe I open an awesome red card and end up in red instead of blue. These guys are going to be a big pain in the ass if I have to play against them. Yeah, it's fine. Again, might end up in red, so. Bunch of marginal red cards, but you know. We'll see. Hide that. Hide the Witch's Eye. Well, and to go with our Elspeth, we opened a Spear of Helioid. That is pretty lucky. Now all those tokens get to be 2/2s. Alright, well. Yeah, nothing's gonna be close here. This guy is okay. Much worse than this. I think it's also worse than this. And yeah, we're not taking any. We're not branching into red right now. So, Spear Helioid it is. Alright, well. Are these sold? Alright, they're not humans. I do have a couple humans already, so this card could be a thing in my deck. Probably will not be. I still like my blue cards okay. And I don't know. Yeah, I guess we just want this, right? Like, this card is a powerful card, but I don't think we're lacking in the power department. We got Elspeth and Spear. Definitely want cheap guys to go with Spear. Like, this guy is pretty perfect to go with that. And also, we have some already pretty good blue cards. All right. Well, we can take a Pegasus. We have some number of humans also. Again, gets better with Spear just because it's a cheap evasion creature, but I think we still want this guy. Like, we don't really have any spells yet, but even if you copy, like, one thing per match or something, that's still pretty strong. I mean, a 2/3 for 3 is still not horrible. So, sure. Now, Battlewise Valor's value goes up a little bit. Because of A, this, and B, Artisan of Forms. Like, we just want ways to do that. Snarecaster still could be better. Clear deck is looking to be pretty aggressive. And also, this card is pretty sweet, but I don't think it's what we're really trying to do. I think we have a reasonably aggressive deck that just randomly has this guy at the top end. Yeah, I don't know. I do like Valor. Kind of hope to table one. I think I'd rather just take the Snarecaster here. I do hope I get a Valor, and I'll probably be mad at myself if I don't and didn't take that one, but. Oh, Annul's a somewhat reasonable sideboard card. Not great, but if you're playing against gods or something. I don't think we're going to be playing this Labyrinth guy. Though there's like a small chance we splash him, I guess. But yeah, I'll just take the Annul. Ooh, Soldier of the Pantheon, jeez. I mean, protection from multicolor is not super relevant in this format, but this is like getting close to my constructed deck with the soldier and the spear and stuff, so just having a 2/1 on turn one's makes me happy enough with how aggressive this deck is so far. Well, there's some possibility I could take this because it triggers this. Or just randomly triggers this. It's not really going to be good in combat, but it could be good, like, just end of turn pump or whatever. That's pretty narrow, though. Nah, I don't think I want to do that. I'm going to take this. Might splash it, probably won't. Alright, yeah. Definitely needed that. If I get a second one, I'll be incredibly happy. Probably not splashing two rages. Have like a decent amount of white devotion, so this guy could actually be kind of sweet in my deck. So. Don't really need any of this. Yeah. So it's probably the best card in the back, but. Sure, I guess I'll take one of these now. Yeah, alright. We're in business. That second Batwise Valor is a pretty big boon for this deck. Alright, so we're not gonna play the Hoplite. We're not gonna play the Chronicler. I guess this is reasonably good against me. I have a decent number of X1s. Alright, will I open a third white rare? I hope so.
Woo!